friends, welcome to my channel Sushant Chess Quiz. As I have been telling you that the lectures or lessons whatever I am making here, they are made in such a way that parents can teach their kids, okay, and older kids can learn on their own. So today we are going to continue with the same topic, concepts of attack and supports. First we saw near the king, then we saw for material game how we do. And today we are going to practice them on empty squares, the squares which are not occupied by any piece. So for very small kids, it doesn't make any difference. We may tell them this concept or we may not tell them. We can just do them like a practice position. Okay, let's see. Okay, so let's see what is the difference. So when we look at the attacks and supports, always we try to look at the squares near the king first. So here what we see, that the queen on c2 is attacking the h7 square. Okay, it's not occupied by any piece. So what happens is, whenever we want to enter to that square, we see how many attacks, how many people are attacking there, how many pieces are attacking there, and how many opponent has on that square. So what is happening, it's an empty square, so we'll count attacks for both. But the one who is entering first has to ensure that he has more. Okay, we'll be doing some exercises on that. So here we see that the queen is one and the knight is second. So two pieces are attacking there. Okay, and if we look for black, we see that only the king is protecting there. So king has one attack here and the queen and knight, they are both are attacking there. So as if there is a piece over there, same way we'll capture. So we enter that square. So we are not capturing anything here, we just enter that square. Queen gives check. Okay, king cannot take the queen because of the knight. So the king moves to f8 square, and next move, white played the queen to h8. So here there were no attacks, no supports. Okay, so one attack, sorry, and no supports. So no black attacks were there. So queen goes to h8. And king cannot move to e7 or e8 because of the rook. Queen is also guarding e8. So it has become a checkmate. So basically, when we see empty squares, there is not much of a difference. We'll look at few cases where we can feel that there is some difference. Let's see. Let's go to the next one. Okay. So here we have the next position. It's black to play. Okay. So let's see where the black pieces are attacking. So we see that the queen is attacking on the h2 square near the king first, but we see there is just one attack and the king is providing support. So one attack, one support, we cannot capture there. Queen is also attacking the a3 pawn, same case over there, one attack, but here there are even two supports, one the pawn, then the queen. Okay, we can't capture over there. So now we see that these two rooks and the queen, all the three are in the same line. And all the three are attacking this square d1, see, which is an empty square. So the side who is entering first has to ensure that he has more attacks over there. Okay, because the side, once we enter there, the opponent will capture. So we will have to have one extra over there on that square. So let's see. So white has two over here. Okay, so queen and the rook, and black has three. So black is able to come there first. First the rook comes. Rook gives check to the king. So now he captures with the smaller piece. Rook takes the rook. Now queen takes the rook. It's a check again. So queen has to capture this. Okay. And finally the rook takes the queen. And see, it has become a checkmate. King can't move anywhere. We can't capture the rook. And nothing can block the check. So it has become a checkmate. So attacks have to be same way more then the opponent's attack. That is it. Let's go to the next one. Now we see some different cases. Okay, so here we have the next position. So let's start seeing the attacks and supports. So we see that the both white knights are ahead and they can attack near the king. So we see the knight attacks the bishop. Okay, there is one attack and there is also one support. So the capture here will just lead to an exchange of bishop and knight. So white also saw that he has two attacks on the c6 square. So one knight from a5 is attacking and the other knight from d4 is attacking the c6 square, and black has only one attack on the c6 square. So let's see what the knight does. White plays the a5 knight to the c6 square. Actually, he can play the other knight also, but he uses the corner knight first. This knight is well placed in the center. So anyways, bishop takes the knight. And now again knight takes the bishop. It's a check to the king, and the knight also attacks the rook. Okay, these all we will be learning. Knight is attacking two pieces at a time. It's called a knight fork. Okay, now the king attacks the knight, and now knight captures the rook. So white got this whole rook for free, and he is standing two pieces up. So we understood how the pieces provide attack and support. Let's take some cases. What happens with the pawns? Okay, let's go to next one. So here we have the next position. Here let's see how the things change when the pawn wants to occupy that square, any square. Okay. So we see that this pawn wants to reach the d5 square. So if we want to play the pawn over there, so what, where many people go wrong is they count this pawn itself. Okay, the pawn itself cannot protect it. So when the pawn goes there, it should have enough supports. Okay, let's see now. When this pawn will reach the d5 square, black will have one attack with this pawn, second attack with this pawn, and third by the knight. Okay, and when this pawn is reaching d5, we note that there are only two supports, this pawn and the knight. So when the pawn is reaching there, the black's attacks are more than our support. So what can happen is black can take with the pawn. Okay, now of course knight cannot take, knight will be taken by the pawn. Then pawn takes, and now if black wants to exchange, he will take with the knight. Then knight takes the knight, and pawn takes the knight. So what has happened in this process is white lost his pawn. Okay, the pawn which he played to d5, because the attacks, black attacks on that pawn were more. So the side who is entering first, he has to ensure that the attacks and supports are equal that time, after the pawn goes to that square. Okay, let's make small change to this position and understand. So just we'll take this same position and make a minor change and see how the attacks and supports work. Let's say in the same position the white rook was on d1. Okay, now what happens? Now when white plays the pawn to the d5 square, now we see the difference that this rook, knight and the pawn, three are supporting the pawn. Attacks are three, supports are three. So all that will happen is an exchange of pieces. So see now, pawn takes the pawn. Again we take the pawn. Now again pawn or knight, whoever takes, pawn takes the pawn. Now see, we have two attacks, one support. So knight takes the pawn first. Rook cannot take, rook will be gone for a knight. Okay. So now again knight captures the knight. And now rook captures the knight. So now the position has become equal. All the exchanges have happened on the d5 square. So both are fighting for the same square. So that is why counting of attacks and supports is very important. So this was all about attacks and supports. We gave three chapters to this. And those who understood the chapter, for them it's just an exercise. Otherwise, it's how to treat the empty squares, we saw. So do subscribe, like and share if you are enjoying the content. Do post on the comment section if you have any queries. Okay, thanks for your time.